let me start. Okay, so let's watch the video. Here it goes. Okay, so there's the chimes and it was writing and then it just evolves. So there's no lot of musical cues as the previous one where you had all this jumping and like the gling and everything. Mm-hmm. It's not a lot of that. It's just the simple fact that there's wind chimes and the letters are getting written and that's it. So pretty easy. If you want to, we can start off like with the wind. Like first have like wind surrounding the audience, and then like you hear these chimes start, or first you just hear the wind, and then the chimes appear as you swoosh the letters across the screen, and then you hear like the wind fade off. Since they come from the left hand side, and the letters fade off into the right hand side. Maybe the wind starts off on the left-hand side of the speakers, and then you hear the chimes, and then it, like, blows the letters in, and then it leaves, you know, through the right speaker. That way it kind of whooshes across the audience. And then for the whole home entertainment logo that it says on the bottom, I mean, before we used more of, like, singing as the dun, you know, like, the final tag note, maybe this one can have a musical note to end it with.
Okay.
I mean, that's my thought.
Unfortunately, I didn't save the wind that we were listening to earlier. But I see where you're coming from for that. And do you have some instruments in mind that you want to use?
No, because I'm mostly just relying upon the chimes. I mean, really, that's the main focus.
Okay. So, I'm hoping everything is separate, because that'd be painful.
You don't think it's able?
Oh, I don't think, I'm hoping everything is set up right. Okay.
Yeah, I know, I hear that.
But, now you can pull out some. I'm thinking we may need some synth.
Sounds like 1930s horror movie. It's like you have this lighthearted chimes, then you have this heavy bass instrument.
Okay. Let's get this looping so we can not have to focus on stopping and starting.
Okay.
So it's gonna keep playing chimes.
Okay.
And we can just do some experimenting over the top of that. So I think we need some.
Really,
I'm gonna try and mess with
you.
What's that?
I said you really want that synth. That's what you were playing earlier. I like that. I do like that.
Now just finding the right octave. Maybe it's the right sort of sound. Because it's the right sort of sound, but
Mm-hmm.
called the Colossus Pad. I would like to mess with that myself. Too warbly. Did I just do that one?
I think you did.
Okay, both of those sound the same. The chimes are probably gonna get annoying pretty fast.
At least it's just not me. Not exactly it.
Not quite, but... Feel free to change. You can use the instruments and all this most of things.
Holy cow, I like the sound of that, but...
I do too.
Toned down.
I like that. I like that too. Whatever you were doing. In the tune. I like that. I think that's a good one. I think that's the one. I really do. I think that's the one. That's it. That's the one.
Okay.
Spot where you were playing it. Yeah, that's exactly it. That's exactly the one. What do you think of that one?
Yeah, I actually like it. I just kind of screwed around as far as, musically wise, as far as what notes I'm hitting.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know if you like this. I'll try and play along with it.
That's okay. You can just play it and listen.
Okay.
I like it without it too.
Yeah, what I'm concerned about is this. That builds up that.
Yeah.
You know, I'm concerned about that. Maybe. Just a different melody.
I don't know, it's just the one that you did first really seemed appropriate. That's the one. Did you just do what the original one that you did?
Pretty much.
Yeah, I think that's the one. It just sounds right to me.
I was getting a little bit more fancy with what I was.
Yeah, but the basic arrangements of the notes are in the same general area.
Part of what's key to that is the right build-up, hitting the right notes that... Because this is an effect that echoes.
Right.
And so the right notes need to echo at the right time, so that build-up is proper. So...
So different than the rest of them.
Ah.
Oh, I went down. That's hellfire.
Awesome. These are high morphs. And there's low to high morphs. Demo track of that,
right.
Of that other, of this thing that you like.
Okay.
And then we can see if, you know, sort of step aside and listen to it.
Right.
Just because when you're playing it, it's different than when you step aside and listen to it.
And
we
actually listen to it.
Yeah.
Okay.
So then there'll be also other freedoms for, as far as putting whatever else on top of that too. So, we mess around with it for a little bit to sort of see what kind of time frame there is.
So, I mean, it can zoom in for longer. That's fine.
Yeah. And then the... It can... Right? Your picture...
Yeah, no, yeah. It can fade out. You just, like, have the logo, other logo fade out.
You can choose how fast you want to fade
out. Yeah, I can choose how long the fade is.
Thank you.
Pushing the letters across the screen. And then as soon as it ends with the S at the end, then it goes done. I think that would... Or do you like it better with... As soon as the letters arrive, that's when that note hits. No, you're right. Because maybe that... that when you're doing that, it sounds more like letters writing across the screen. Actually, you're right. Well, we can try it again. So... Same amount. And then it's the one with the full blank screen because the DVDs are starting. Does it open on this one?
Time already.
Oh wow.
fade out. Like when I take my foot off the pedal,
no, I know. Yeah, I know.
Like it immediately fades out, but I'll have a smoother.
Yeah, fade out. That's fine.
And actually, it'll be nicer with reverb on top of it as well. Like, I'll do it anyways. I'm gonna just like hit record here.